rare case of genuine train coincidence. She was unconsciously trending. She's not someone who ever pays attention to whether something is trending hard. So she wasn't aware that almost all rooms you go in Melbourne for the last few months have someone wearing black and white horizontal stripes. And it's not exclusive to French people anymore. Next to me in the front passenger seat was my friend, who was talking about how she's 90% lesbian, 10% straight. She's famous for her striking eyebrows. She was eating a borek. As we drove, I told them about how whenever I take public transport, my thing is I always touch on and touch off using Mikey. And then one of my trademarks is reminding people to drink more water. Then finally, I told them that my current catchphrase was, everything's falling into place. That was my catchphrase at the time, and it's still my main catchphrase at the moment. One way to use it is, if someone asks you how are things, or what's been happening, you say, everything's falling into place, and then you answer. It's a way of framing whatever's going on in your life positively, the power of words. Around 3 hours later, we reached the main campsite at Wilson's Prom, and we put on formal clothes. We were out there for our friend's wedding. The girls put on makeup, we got changed, and walked down to Tidal River, where the ceremony was about to take place. The bride and groom began to exchange their vows surrounded by a large crowd of people gathered on a sandbank at the edge of the river. It was late afternoon. The groom, a renowned artist, read out his vows. He read for a while until he suddenly reached a point where he realized he had forgotten some of his speech cards. He checked with the best man who didn't have them. So he was forced to recite from memory the last part he'd written, taking long pauses as he spoke. I think he said, after I'm dead and my body is dust, blowing in the wind, I'll still love you forever until the end of time. Something along those lines. I can't remember his exact words. It would have been inappropriate to be writing it all down while he was speaking. The girl with red hair turned around to face me once the ceremony ended. Her eyes were watering. I asked if she had been crying, but she said it was just the wind making her eyes water, which I completely believed to be true at the time. I admit that even though I didn't know her that well, there had been several times when I had wondered if it was possible that I was in love with this girl. An Ayurvedic doctor once explained attraction to me in terms of elements: earth, air, fire, water, and ether, saying that we are attracted to those elements which we don't have in ourselves. In this case, she was pure fire, and maybe I needed more fire. In front of the hall where the party was about to start, someone I don't really know, who has their own fashion label, was in the process of lighting a joint. It was cannabis. As I walked past, I said, that smells good. He said it was organic and offered me some of it in the spirit of sharing. Some people call it chiba or weed, chuf, buddha or buds. Some people in Australia call it field green or grass.
Thank you. Thank you. I